Welcome to the Penrith Solar Centre Solar Academy. Today we're going to be diving into how the solar rebate works. And in this video, we're going to cover understanding that the rebate actually isn't a rebate after all, small scale technology certificates or STCs. We're going to explain them. We're going to explain the purpose of the STC system. We're going to cover how to calculate your solar rebate. And we're going to calculate how to maximize your savings utilizing the STC scheme. By the end of this video, you'll be across everything relating to the solar and government rebate. Let's get straight into it. One of the most commonly asked questions that I get asked, even for people who aren't in the market for solar, is the government rebate still around, or does the government have a rebate for solar panels? And the simple answer is actually yes, but it's not quite that simple, because you see, the rebate, it isn't actually a rebate. Instead, what we have is a small-scale renewable energy scheme, or the SRES. However, in the article, we're going to dive far deeper into the nitty-gritty of STC schemes and the government rebate. So let's jump in. The rebate, newsflash, isn't actually a rebate. The rebate is nothing more than the small scale renewable energy scheme, which was introduced in 2015 by the Labor government. And we talk about this in small scale technology certificates, or STCs. That is the actual quantifiable value of said rebate on your proposal. Now, the STC scheme was actually brought in to incentivize the uptake of solar installations, and it was designed to make the upfront cost of solar more reachable for mums and dads to be able to install solar on their place of work or on their home. STCs are calculated based on the system size, so being the more panels or wattage that you actually install, the greater the government rebate or STCs that you're going to get. It also depends on your location. The more sun or peak sun hours that you get during the day means the more yield your solar system will produce. So, sorry for those from Tassie, you'll actually get less STCs than someone who lives in far north Queensland. It also depends on the installation year, meaning how long does your system have to run by the time that the SRES scheme is actually phased out in 2030. So in 2024, we have a total of 6 years left on this scheme. At the end of year six, the scheme will be no longer and we will not have a government rebate left. So now that we've discovered that the STC scheme or solar rebate is in fact not actually a rebate, well then what exactly is it? You see, big corporates and big polluters in Australia who generate tons and tons of emissions have to actually buy these small-scale technology certificates in exchange for the pollution that they put into our atmosphere. By them buying these certificates, it funds mums and dads and businesses that want to invest in solar an upfront style discount to make solar more readily accessible for you, therefore generating clean energy and offsetting the emissions that the big polluters put into our atmosphere every single day. So STCs were designed and to incentivize the uptake of solar to offset the pollution to help Australia meet our net zero targets. How are STCs exactly calculated though? Well, it's three main components that will dictate the actual STC value that you get back. The first one is the system size that you install. Any system up to 99 kilowatts is eligible for STCs. Whether it be residential or commercial, it's all actually the same quantity of STCs based on wattage. So the more wattage of panels you install, the greater the amount of STCs. The next part of the equation is the location. The closer to far north Queensland you are and the more sun you get throughout the year, the more quantity of STCs that you get. This is simply because your solar system gets more peak sun hours throughout the year and will generate more yield, meaning more offset of emissions. The other thing that goes into deciding the value and quantity of STCs that you get is the installation year. If you had have installed a solar system in 2015, you would have got the maximum amount of STCs available. This scales down for the next 15 years all the way to 2030, when the scheme is going to be phased out. So if you leave it till 2029 to install solar, you can bet your bottom dollar that the STCs you receive are going to be the absolute minimum available. So in terms of when is the right time to buy solar and collect the biggest benefit you can from the Australian government, the sooner the better. Every 1st of January at each year, 2025, 2026, the actual amount of STCs that you receive from the government will reduce by about 1/15. Unfortunately, there are no current national or federal rebates available for battery storage. Some state governments like South Australia and Queensland have actually introduced a statewide battery rebate or incentive, which has seen the uptake of batteries be absolutely accelerated. Here in New South Wales, we have not yet seen a battery rebate or incentive. Fingers crossed, we might see one in the future. I wouldn't hold your breath though. The thing with battery storage is that whilst we do keep energy for nighttime, it technically doesn't actually offset any of the big energy polluters' emissions. The reason for that is because all we're doing is keeping our excess solar energy for use at nighttime. When we produce solar during the day, it doesn't actually matter if you don't use it because someone else in your neighborhood is going to. So as far as the government's concerned, without putting any additional infrastructure in place or rebates around battery storage, their goal is still being achieved by reducing net emissions. The process of STCs being sold to these big corporations looks a little like this. Your STCs will actually be given to you in form of an upfront discount, which will be clearly shown on your proposal. The proposal will show the quantity of STCs that you're going to receive, and it will also show the value of each STC. Now, the value is a bit of a market. It fluctuates day to day. Since 2021, we've seen the actual STC be worth as much as it's ever going to be, which is a market cap of $40 per STC. So by the time someone like Penrith Solar Centre installs your solar system and gives you the STCs as an upfront rebate, we will then sell them on to an STC aggregator. The STC aggregator will give them to us for around $38.50 per STC, sometimes spiking at $39. So how exactly do I maximise this STC scheme and get the most value for money that I possibly can? Well, the answer is quite simple. The more panels you install, or the more wattage, the greater the value of STCs that you will receive, therefore the biggest upfront discount. Now that ties into value for money on your solar system. At Penrith Solar Centre, if you're looking at a 6.6 kilowatt system, which is something that actually suits almost no one, but is thrown around so much by the big scary sales companies, that will cost you around $11,000. That exact same quality system with N-phase microinverters and great panels at 15 kilowatts is literally going to only cost you $5,000 more. And it is more than double the system size. The reason that that's possible are two main key points. Number one is that we use in-house installers, so we're paying a day of labor regardless of the size of the system that you install. But number two, and most relevant to this video, is that you're actually getting more STCs. Now, in the current time that we are in right now, STCs cover the value of solar panels. Think about solar panels on your install as if they're for free. Now, don't forget that just because you have free solar panels, you still have a whole heap of supporting components that go with your solar system, such as an N-phase microinverter per panel. You'll need racking and supporting equipment per panel. And the more panels you put on, simply the bigger your system is, therefore requiring larger cable sizes and larger supporting balance of system components. So, to answer the question of how to maximize your savings with STCs, the bigger system that you install on your home is always going to be the best choice and is going to give you the best return and maximize your savings from the STC scheme. I've actually never had anyone come back to me and say, "Jake, the solar system I bought was too big." No one ever regrets going the bigger system. And the more you take advantage of the government rebate, the more you feel like you've just got the best value for money out of paying taxes in Australia. So when you're getting proposals built to put solar and battery storage on your home, make sure you ask the simple question, does this price include my government rebate or all my STCs that I'm eligible for? And the answer should certainly be yes. And most of the time, it will be given to you in form of an upfront discount on your solar system. Now that you've watched this video, you should have a great understanding on how the STC scheme works in Australia, and that any system up to 99 kilowatts is actually eligible for an upfront government rebate or STCs. I hope that you've got great value out of this and that this video has helped you navigate your way through choosing the right solar company to install on your home. I'm Jake from the Penrith Solar Centre. We'll catch you on the next one.